So we'll start now volume. We'll start a discussion of volume. Already in our last classes, some 2-3 classes, we have already discussed about surface areas. So surface area of cuboid we have finished. Surface area of cylinder also is finished. Surface area of cone and surface area of sphere. Now we are going to discuss separately about volumes. So the very first one from exercise 13.5 onwards, we are going to discuss about volumes of various geometrical shapes. So first one is volume of cuboid. Volume of cuboid and cube also. And cube also. So we can let me draw a cuboid. Yes. So this is a cuboid. In this cuboid you are having length. A specific length is there. We are having specific breadth and there will be a specific height. Whereas in cube, length will be equal to breadth will be equal to height. Okay. So in this L, this is also L, this is also L. So in this you can say that L is equal to B is equal to H. Here this is cuboid, where L is specific, breadth is specific and height is specific. In case of cube, all these are equal. All the six sides are equal in length. Okay, gentlemen? Right. So volume of cuboid, what we are going to study now, volume of a cuboid will be equal to length into breadth into height. And its unit will be in cube unit. Or square unit was there in surface area, here cube unit. So unit will be in cube form. Okay. Similarly, volume of a cube will be equal to L cube. And that is, its unit is also in unit. So this particular part we are going to discuss now. Let us solve some of the questions from this exercise 13.5. Okay, so question number 1. We will start question number 1 itself. Always I am in favor of solving question number 1 in each and every exercise. Okay, question number 1 we should always start with that. Okay, you know that 1 is considered as good omen everywhere. If suppose you want to donate something to somebody, so people, they are not donating in even number, like 100 rupees it is not given, 101 rupees will be given, 111 rupees will be given. Okay, so like this, so 1 is considered as good omen, right? Okay, so we will also start our exercise with question number 1. So a match box measures 4 cm into 2.5 cm into 1.5 cm. So a match box is there which is in the form of cuboid. We all have seen match box. Okay. So this is just like in the form of cuboid. And its length is given to us, L is equal to 4 cm. Its breadth is given to us as 2.5 cm. And its height is given to us, H, is equal to 1.5 cm. What will be the volume of a packet containing 12 such boxes? Okay, so first we need to find volume of one match box. Volume of one match box. So will be equal to L into B into H. So L into B into H. Then L is 4, B is 2.5. And H is 1.5. So 4 into 2.5 will give you as 10. See gentlemen, very easily, 25 400, 25 into 4 is 100, correct or not? So forget for 1 second that this decimal is there. Multiply 25 into 400. So if you are doing 100 here, then what decimal will come here? So it will become 10 only. Okay, so you can write immediately. So this is 10 into 1.5. Again this 10 will be utilized to clear this decimal. Okay, and this one will be giving you 15 watt centimeter cube. Do not forget to write the unit. Otherwise, unnecessarily, you may sometimes lose complete mark. But generally, no pupil or you can say stone hearted, no examiner. So they will be deducting sometimes 1 mark or 1.5 mark. So please do not forget to write this unit at the last. In between, if you are not writing, no problem. But at the last, your answer should contain unit. Centimeter cube or for surface area, centimeter square or meter square, whatever the case may be. At the last, your answer should speak about units. Understood? Okay. Right. So, volume of one matchbox is 15 centimeter cube we have found. Here, question is asked that volume of a packet containing 12 such boxes. So, volume of the packet containing 12 match boxes. So, volume is then 12 into 15 centimeter cube. Correct? So, it will be 180 centimeter cube total. Understood? So total volume of the packet containing 12 match boxes, it will be 180 centimeter cube. Right. So this was very easy. Just we have put in formula and we have got the answers. Okay, let us go for question number 3 now. Okay. We will solve question number 3. Question number 2 you solve in your home as a homework. In case of difficulty, please ask me in next class. Question number 3 is what? A cuboidal bezel is 10 meter long. Now again a cuboidal bezel is given to us. Bezel you know?
Yes sir.
Yes. So just like utensil, something we can keep it in liquid form. That is called bezel, whether it is solid or liquid. So that will be decided later that what we are going to keep in that particular bezel, but it is in the form of cuboid. Okay, so a cuboidal bezel, we are talking about third question, not second. Cuboidal bezel is 10 meter long, so its length is given to us as 10 meter long and 8 meter wide. So this breadth is given to us as 8 meter. Width or breadth, same. Okay, right. How high must it be made to hold 380 cubic meters of a liquid? Okay, so what should be the height? We need to find the height. And this cuboidal bezel is holding 380 cubic meters of a liquid. So volume of this cuboidal bezel is already 380 meter cubic meters of a liquid. So this volume, this vessel will contain 380 meter cube volume of the liquid. Now what should be the height? That question is being asked to us from this. Volume of this cuboidal vessel means length into breadth into height. And that should be equal to 380 meter cube. Length is given to us as 10 meter, breadth is given to us as 8 meter, height we do not know, which we need to find. And this will be equal to 380 meter cube. From here, we can write that h is equal to 380 divided by 10 into 8 meter cube. Okay, so this 0 and this 0 will get cancelled. Let us cancel this 2, 4 and 2, 19. Okay. So our h, better, will not write meter cube now here. Okay. Because h will be in meter. Right. So 4, 4, 16. Then 3. Point 4, 7, 28. And then 20. So 5. Okay, so 4.75 meter should be the height of this cuboidal bezel. Okay, so the height of the vessel, cuboidal vessel, should be 4.75 meter. Right, gentlemen?
Okay,
good. Now we will solve question number 6 in this particular. So 3 is there, okay, we will solve question number 5. Okay, we will solve question number 5. Right. If it is required, question number 6 also we will solve, no problem, don't worry. Okay, we will solve question number 6. Let us solve question number 5 and 6 both. So question number 5 now. Okay, so the capacity of a cuboidal tank is 50,000 liters of water. Again, a cuboidal tank is given to us. Capacity is given to us, and capacity is nothing but volume only. Okay, so capacity of a tank is equal to volume of the tank. And which is given to us as 50,000 liters, 50,000 liters of water. Okay, so it can contain 50,000 liters. Find the breadth of the tank. We need to find the breadth of the tank if its length and depth. So length L is given to us as 2.5 meter. Its height, that is depth, okay, so that is called depth, is 10 meter, right? We need to find its breadth, okay? B is equal to question mark. Okay, gentlemen? Right? No problem. See, question is given to you in liter. Understand? Question is given to you here in liter, and here dimensions are given to you in
meter.
Okay, so that particular part you must take into consideration, that okay, 1000 centimeter cube will be equal to 1 liter, gentlemen. See here, okay. So this particular part you must understand. Now this 50,000 liter should be converted into meter cube. Right or not? Should be converted into meter cube. So let us convert this first one. So 1 liter is equal to 1000 centimeter cube. Okay? Now this is centimeter cube, not meter cube. So in meter cube what will be there? So 1000 into 10 to the power minus 2, 1 centimeter is equal to 10 to the power minus 2 meter, okay, or 1 by 100 meter, so 3 meter. So this is given to you as 10 to the power 3 into 10 to the power minus 6 meter cube, which is equal to 10 to the power minus 3 meter cube. Listen here. Okay, listen here and see. Understand first. Understood? Understood or not? You understood. Okay, so 10 to the power minus, 10 to the power minus, I am writing that you have understood. How this 10 to the power minus 2 has come and how this cube has come, that you have understood. See, 1000 already it is there, 1 liter is equal to 1000 centimeter cube. This is the formula, standard formula. But our dimensions are given in meter only, 2.5 meter, 10 meter. It means here it should be in meter. So this centimeter, so 1 centimeter is equal to what? 10 to the power minus 2 meter. Or I will tell you. 1 meter is equal to how many centimeter?
100
centimeter. Correct? Then 1 centimeter is equal to what? 1 by 100 meter? 1 centimeter is equal to 1 by 100 meter. 1 by 100 meter means what? 10 to the power minus 2. 10 to the power minus 2. So 10 to the power minus 2. So 1 meter is 10 to the power minus 2. But meter, centimeter cube is there. So meter cube, so 3 times. 10 to the power minus 6. Here already 10 to the power 3 is there. So 10 to the power minus 6 into 10 to the power of 3. So you know that this will get added, 3 minus 6. So this has become 10 to the power minus 3. Understood or not? Very good. So your 1 liter is equal to 10 to the power minus 3 meter cube. Then 50,000 liters is equal to what? 50,000 liters will be equal to 10 to the power minus 3 into, see, 1 liter is equal to this much. 50,000 liters will be equal to this into 50,000. So 50,000. Right. So 10 to the power minus 3 can be write as 50 into 10 to the power of 3. Can I write as 50 into 10 to the power of 3? So 10 to the power of minus 3, 10 to the power of 3 will become 0. Minus 3 plus 3 will become 0 at the top. So 50 into 10 to the power minus 3 plus 3 or not? Law of indices? Law of exponents and indices already you are knowing. So this one will get cancelled. So 10 to the power 0 is equal to 1 only. Okay. So it means 50 what meter cube?
50 meter.
Understood? So your volume which was given in 50,000 liters, that is equivalent to 50 meter cube. Now here we need to find breadth. So volume of the tank already it is given 50,000 liter and which is 50 meter cube. So your length into breadth into height will be equal to 50 meter cube. We need to find breadth. Okay, L is given to us as 2.5 and height is given to us, breadth is as it is, height is given to us as 10 meter, so 50. Now this 0, okay, I will take that side. So 50 divided by 10 into 2.5, gentlemen. This 0 and this 0 will get cancelled. Okay, for your understanding, otherwise 2.5 into 2 will give you 5. 2.5 into 2 will give you 5. Otherwise, what you can do? 2.5 you can write divided by 10. So 5 by 25 into 10. Like this, it will be there. Okay, so 5, 5 and 5, 2. So breadth will be 2 meter, gentlemen. You have understood, gentlemen, this one? Breadth will be equal to 2 meters. So here little bit tricky was there that where 50,000 liters has to be converted into meter cube. Right? After that it will become easy. Just simply put in formula and you will be able to get it. Should we solve question number 6 now? You have understood, Bharat? Bharat, you have understood? This one you have understood? Okay. What about Kilay? Very good. Okay. Can I have it now?
So.
Okay. So just note it down. So you have seen that how easy it is, but little bit this type of question you are expecting in examination. In examination, most probably this type of question will be given to you where slightly conversion has to be done. Okay, so that conversion part if you are knowing, it will become easy, otherwise you may commit mistake. So that is there. If we want, we can convert it into centimeter also. If this one, then we have to write this along with 1000 centimeter cube, we can use it. Okay. So we will go for solving next question.
The same as the
sixth question is same. A village having a population of 4000 squares requires, okay, so that is on the basis of population. Let us see. Once we have told that we will be solving question number 6. So let us solve. Okay. Let us stick to our words. So question number 6 also will solve. No problem. Okay. A village having a population of 4000. Population. Okay. So, you can say population of a village is 4000. What is 4000? Number of persons in that village? Okay. requires 150 liters of water per head per day. 150 liters of water per head and per day. Okay. So, right, they need one person need 150 liters of water per day. Very good. Now it has a tank measuring 20 meter into 15 meter into 6 meter tank available. So it is, its dimensions are 20 into 15, 20 meter into 15 meter into 6 meter. This is the dimension of the tank which is available in that particular village. For how many days will the water of this tank last? So we need to find the number of days that tank will hold water for villagers. This one we need to find. Okay. Right. So population of a village is 4000. One person need 150 liters of water per day. So per day, it means, okay, so volume of water needed per day by full village, so will be equal to 4000 into 150 liters of water. Okay. 150 liters of water. Right, gentlemen, so here 150 liters of water is there. Now 1 liter is equal to what I told you in previous question. How many meter cube? 1 liter will be equal to what? 10 to the power minus 3 meter cube? Yes or no? So 10 to the power minus 3 meter cube, 1 liter is equal to. So here also liter is there, so we can write as 4000 into 150 into 10 to the power minus 3 meter cube. So 4 into 150 into 10 to power of 3 into 10 to power of minus 3 meter cube. 10 to power of 3 and 10 to power of minus 3, so 10 to the power 0, which will be equal to 1. Okay, so this is giving you 600. So 600 meter cube of water each day the village needs. Okay, gentlemen, right. Let us see that volume of tank is what. Now you will write here. So volume of tank will be equal to L into B into H. So 20 into 15 into 6. Meter cube. Right? So, this is the volume of tank. This much water they need per day. Now, number of days the water, number of days the water lost. Water in tank lost will be equal to, you can say this 20 into 15 into 6, that is volume of tank divided by per day what it is required, so 600. So this 600, right, then 20, 5 is 100, and then 5, 3 is 15. Okay, so this is 3 days only, only for 3 days that water tank will be holding that water which is sufficient for villagers, 4000 people. Only 3 days that tank, again it needs to be filled, means every 3 day, every 3rd day that tank has to be filled. Yes or no? Third day it is not there. 3 days it will be lasting. Fourth day again it needs to be filled. So in this way municipal corporation can have a plan that okay, that village needs water every fourth day. This village needs water every such day, like this. So this planning is there. Do you know that here where is the water tank? Water tank is you can say near to new bus stand. You have seen?
In Salem.
Near to new bus stand, two big water tanks are there. So two big water tanks are there. Then one water tank is this side also. You can say, towards your home. Correct? Okay. So there are so many water tanks. In Hastampatti also one water tank is there. So in this way to supply that water to various areas, one collectively at one central place water tank is made. All those water tanks are getting supplied from Mettur Dam. Right? So originally water is coming from Mettur Dam only. And then it is supplied. So for 3 days that water will be lasting.
Per day they are using
600 meter cube.
6 lakh liter.
So that liter will be used. Huh? Okay. Right. So we will stop here only today for this particular exercise.
Remaining.
Yes. Remaining.